morning, teachers. Welcome to our school to attend the English special subject. And my name is Kim. I'm going to talk about the theory of English special subject. My presentation is divided into two parts. Topic: aims of the English special subject, and topic: procedure and teaching methods used in one period. Firstly, I will begin with topic aims of the English special subject. The first aim, number one, applying the information technology in teaching and learning English. Technology plays a very important role in English teaching. In language teaching and learning, we have a lot to choose from the world of technology, such as radio, TV, CD-ROM, computers, the internet, electronic, dictionary, email, blogs, and audio classes, PowerPoint, videos, DVDs, or VCDs, etc. Technology provides so many options as making teaching interesting and also making teaching more productive in terms of improvements. To promote students' communication capacity, to improve teaching effectiveness, to improve interaction between teacher and student, creates a context for language teaching. The second aim, find some ways to improve reading, writing skills combined with speaking, listening skills. As you know, until now, we have a lot of ways to improve listening and speaking skills, but for reading and writing skill, there is less. So through this English special subject today, we will find the common ways to teach reading and writing skills. Now I move on to topic B, procedure and teaching methods used in one period. There are many methods that can be applied to teaching this class, but we cannot use only one period. The methods we choose is based on the degree of compliance with our students and might be suitable for lecture presentations today. Some teaching apps and software used in this lesson: Zoom, Projector, Adaplus, Fire 11, Computer Sound Equipment. This is the procedure and teaching methods used in one period. Step one is in warm-up, and we use lesson game. In this step, we use the methods motivating children through games, using games to steer the atmosphere at the beginning of the lesson and reveal the names of some famous stories they have learned to amuse students. The new lesson, we have three parts. The number one, the part four, the read and tick, yes or no. We have three activities here. Activity one, look at the picture, identify the character, say the activity. Activity two, read and tick, yes or no. In this part, we use methods generated reading, teaching activity. Let students look and talk about the pictures by answering some questions to get the related information. Ask students answer about themselves. Next, activity three, read and complete. Students must understand and remember the content of the test to do the summarized test about Tom's favorite book. We use interactive activities which emphasize write about your favorite book.
There
are three activities. Activity one is that, activity two write, and activity three check the answers. In this session, we use the methods communicative language teaching handbook. Help students read the gap sentences and think about the words to write. Let students brainstorm and get many vocabularies as much as possible and give students time to write. Ask your students to write an answer on the board to teach us to write answers. Number six, project. In this session, we use the methods basic interpersonal communication skill. Students must interview three classmates about their favorite books and writers. And the last one step, color the stars. In this step, we use the methods self-assessment. Help students review what they have learned and self-assess by coloring the stars. Well, I have just told you about the theory. Thank you for your attention. And do you have any question, any idea, or any comment? Sorry, but we have the last step, consolidation. In this method, we use communicative language teaching. We develop students' interpersonal and interactive communication skills through the class. Teacher tells the class to ask their family members about their favorite books at home. Give students a chance to practice speaking English. And activity two, we use goodbye songs. And we do the methods